No. John, in the 8th chapter, verses 47 through 51. Whoever belongs to God hears what God says. The reason you do not hear is that you do not belong to God. It says some Jews answered him, "Aren't we right in saying that you are a Samaritan and demon possessed? I'm not possessed by a demon," said Jesus, "but I honor my Father, and you do not, and you dishonor me. I am not seeking the glory for myself, but there is one who seeks it, and he is the judge. Very truly I tell you, whoever obeys my word will never see death. Whoever obeys my word will never see death." My brother, who is autistic, says, "Listen." He said, "Listen." He said, "Listen," three times as I was reading the scripture. And now he's saying, "Watch." Not an accident. Like Joan Rivers would say, "Can we talk?" It seems to me, and just if you disagree, I want to open up a conversation. We have to do preachers allow people to have a conversation in a sermon. We call it a dialogue sermon. And that's what happens. We have too few people having a dialogue about things that they say that they believe. Especially in church. Because believe it or not, the preacher doesn't have all the answers. Except at home. Everybody all right? Yes. Jesus says, "If you obey my word." Now he's speaking to a crowd of people who say they belong to God. Just like us. We say that we are disciples of Jesus Christ. That's what we say. But too often, we follow, turn it down just a little bit. We follow things that are completely against. Completely against the Word of God. Now, I'm not saying that we should go around thumping the Bible, because people who thump the Bible are not always following the Word of God. They're simply thumping the Bible. But the bottom line is, Jesus is saying to those, "Listen, you dishonor God and you dishonor me simply because I'm seeking to be obedient to what God has asked me to do in my call. Each and every person here, under the sound of my voice, has a call from God. It is not Reverend Lewis or any other person within this sanctuary to determine whether that's right or wrong, because your relationship with God is your relationship with God. It is not determined by denomination. It is not determined by how long you've been a Christian. It determines about your act. It's determined by your actions, because what? My actions speak louder than words. I would rather be known by my actions as a Christian than to call myself simply Christian and do nothing. Too often, churches are empty because we have the name on the outside, but we do not have any action on the inside. Thank you, David. Somebody's listening. Yeah, I'll give you a little something after service. Now the question becomes, how obedient am I really to the Word of God? Can anybody answer that? This is a dialogue, sir.
Submission?
How much? Were you a wrestler in high school? Okay.
Kickboxer.
Okay. So submission for a wrestler or a kickboxer is determined when they're in a spot. Mm-hmm. And they can't move, and they do something called tap out. Mm-hmm. Is that right?
Yep.
How many have tapped out to God? I got one. I got two. I got four. How about the preacher's wife? I'm serious. Tapping out to God means simply, I have surrendered. I've exhausted my energy to fight any longer. All of my efforts to wrestle away from the situation, my way clearly does not work. I gotta tap out. What a wonderful metaphor. Can I tap out to God, or am I still fighting? I got a friend here, I won't call his name, sitting in the back, rubbing his head, getting a little antsy. I've known this guy, how long have I known you, John?
30 years.
And very often he will say to me, I gotta go to church because God's been good to me. We say that all the time, but it's hard to tap out to God. Why? Because we always, and put it on me, I always think that I got the best answer. Why is it? Roy, why is it so quiet in here? Sorry?
Nobody's just paying attention to what you're saying and trying to figure out an answer.
Good answer, Joe. But generally when I talk to you, you always have an answer, but the fact that you look quiet. Huh?
I don't have no peanut for the wolf.
That's correct.
For in case anybody wants to know what this peanut butter loaf is, many years ago when I moved an IBMer, they were vegetarians of a faith that we know about. And this lady was making something that smelled so good. So I don't know if they gave the recipe, and she attempted to try to make it. But the two attempts, my Saint Bernard would not even try it. And I happened to mention it one day, and Jay hasn't let it go since.
Peanut butter love. Amen. Amen. You know, very often we're willing to try recipes of everybody else, but not try the recipe of God. Am I obedient to God's word? John Clark, talk to me.
Are you asking am I, or are you asking are you?
No. Yeah, that's, you know, I tried this yesterday, and Anastasia did the same thing.
So I said, for am I, not are you?
Yes, that's exactly what she did. So this is what I found when I responded to her. Both.
Mm-hmm.
Both.
It's kind of hard to be obedient when you don't ask. You don't ask, you don't quiet yourself to listen. And I have a hard time doing that.
Asking?
Doing both, yeah. It's not a typical mental habit of my own.
So what makes you tap out to God?
I guess it gets to a pretty emotional state at that point. There have been times that certainly I say, I can't do this. I can't handle it. So I'm in over my head, and then just a feeling of complete despair.
I have to be despairing before I tap out. Are you saying yes or no? I can hear you.
Doesn't have to be that way.
No, I'm saying, how about you?
Yeah, it seems, yeah.
How about you, Sister Elizabeth, my acupuncturist? Preacher's kid.
That's a tough one because I always feel like I have to be in control and able to do everything. Take care of everybody.
Lord have mercy. I know a person who hires a house cleaner, but cleans the house before she comes. And I ask the question, why? Because I don't want anybody to see the dirt.
Christmas.
Is he saying Christmas? It's Christmas.
No Christmas.
Audrey.
Yes.
Audrey. What makes you tap out to God?
I feel very much like Elizabeth. I think most women feel the same, that they have to be in control of everything and do everything right. And it doesn't always work out that way.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. How about you, Michelle? I'm happy to see you, Michelle.
Oh, happy to be here. I was raised in a family where everyone had to be right, and apologies were few and far between. That's just the overall framework. So I think mine probably would come with some anger.
Mm. Just a bit of anger.
Or sometimes a lot.
Sometimes a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So you tap. Excuse me. You tap out with God when you're the most angry.
Yeah, that's it.
Bathroom.
Martha, I never call on you. I know that you love the Ohio Buckeyes, Ohio State. What causes you to tap out with them?
Well, as you know, I like to be in control of my life.
Sometimes I know you like to do
that. It's difficult to do sometimes.
So now, is this a female thing or is this a male thing?
Human.
Right.
It's, who said human?
Right.
It's control. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Especially in the culture that we live in, that's what I know. One tends to want to feel that they should be in control of your circumstances until your back is up against the wall.
Until my back's against the wall.
And then tap out whatever the circumstances that lead you to that.
Right.
I think it's human nature and our culture. Mm-hmm. And it's false.
So are we saying, and here's the question, and I'm bringing this to some closure here. Are we saying that the problem that I have with being Christian is that very often I am not going to allow God to be in control. Until I have to tap out.
I think it's faith. I think that's where faith needs to come in somewhere.
Faith, according to Paul, is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen, which means that at some point in that statement, I have to allow whatever is going to be. That's a difficult, as a farmer would say, that is a difficult road to hoe, because you never know what's going to be ahead of you. But you trust that God is in control more than you are. I'd like to know what you're thinking right now, Cynthia.
To be in control in terms of enjoying everything for everybody, you know. But I also think that, you know, I would like to kind of be in closer connection even as I'm in control. But this way of doing is God's way of doing.
So Jesus, if you see and remember the scripture, he's talking to people who say they know God. And in their response to him, you know, you're a demon. Because, excuse me, because he's simply pursuing what he believes. What he believes that God is asking him to do. Which means that sometimes if you have that tickle in my throat means something. It means that some things that are happening in your life today will supersede even the people that you love. Please excuse me. Can someone get me some water? So in superseding, I think all that, this is where faith comes. Sometimes what I have to say, even if that impacts my relationship.
No crying. Crying. Summer.
Must have been it. It's some coffee.
I think it was a cupcake he ate.
Oh, the peanut butter. The bottom line is that we need to submit to the will of God at all costs, because my life and your life depends upon it. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Are there any other prayer concerns today? Yes?
I pray that you can get better.
Thank you very much. I pray as well. Thank you. Yes, sir.
Prayers for my sister-in-law.